in last year's inaugural match, of course. Tell us what that was like.
Well, it was great. The crowd went wild, you know, especially when this big man got the ball. He was doing his thing and everyone loved him. And it was just incredible atmosphere down here, and that's why I'm very pleased to be back down here.
What do you think Jamie's got coming for you?
Yeah, obviously. Well, I won't be catching him with his pace anyway. Once he sets off, I'm getting nowhere near him with that speed. But as I said, you know, it is a really fun day, and it was a day for, like, even if you're not the biggest football fan, you know, there's a lot of people out there who are, you know, the reality stars, bands, the soaps. So they're known to everyone. So it's come down and have a really good day out.
We've been out in the community recently, haven't we, giving out the cheques which last year Swansea raised to local charities. So, you know, just explain really what that has meant to us.
I think it's nicer when you see it going to people in your city and you can see how it's helping everyone. You know, we've been out to many things with the children's hospital, you know, helping disabled kids with the bikes and things. So it's, you know, it's brilliant, and to see it firsthand, it gives you a buzz.
And Jamie, what does it mean to be involved with raising money for those local charities?
Oh, it's fantastic. You know, I think we raised roughly about £50,000 last year, which is phenomenal. You know, in one day's game, I think it's great. And I think anything towards charities, helping kids, helping local charities, is a wonderful thing. And if you can have fun in the process, that's what it's all about, and that's what it is all about.
We've got a host of other stars ready to name. I think on the same day as yourself today, Jake Quickenden has also been revealed that he's been playing. What do you think about that?
Well, that's brilliant, you know, a legend in the singing, you know, in the jungle doing his sing, and all the girlies will love him anyway. And you've always got to have that person the girlies love, do you know what I mean? Because who was it last year? Was this one?
Dan Osborne,
yeah. He took his top off, everyone was losing their mind. I don't think the girls went home until late, you know. He was great, he was good. I definitely kept my top on, and Ian Beale kept his top on.
Can you give us any? What was it like last year? What was it like to be involved with that?
Oh, it was just brilliant. You know, it was just fun. In the changing room, it was a lot of banter. In the game, it was a lot of banter, real good fun, you know, throughout the whole game. And then afterwards and before, it was just magical. And if you haven't been before, you know, if people haven't been down, just get down here and check it out, you know. It's going to charity at the end of the day.
How does it compare for you to competing in places like Barcelona, Atlanta, to playing in a match like this?
It's totally different, because it's definitely out of my comfort zone. But it's something which is really good fun. It's nothing like when you come from another sport, jumping in and seeing how the great guys do it. And even though it is fun, you know, you do see magical moments while still on the pitch. And with Lee last year doing his thing, I was just like, wow, look at his foot movement there. You know, it is, when you're on that same pitch with these people, it is incredible.
Just finally, what's your message really to fans about today that might not have experienced it last year? What's your message to them to get involved?
Well, just make sure you do get involved. It's all about the charity at the end of the day. It's all about fun. It's all helping underprivileged people. So if you can do that, support it, let's raise more money, it'd be fantastic.